My new Creative Pro arrived, and I'm going to be putting it together. You get this new toy, and, well, it's too big to fit in a box, and you have to put it together. That's kind of what it's like, except you need to be gentle with it. This is the printer head, and I had to tighten in some screws. It was actually kind of hard, because it's tiny and I can't really see it. I'm installing the filament tubes, the green and red. This is a dual-headed printer, so it's capable of printing in two colors. So this is a cone that came with the 3D printer, and the 3D printer comes with a card, and the one that we got was a Creative Pro. Now first you may think it's like, what the heck? But once you use it a little bit more, it won't leak as much. Because, you know, they're new, and they will have problems. Because, you know, like computers, those have problems, but not as many. Now, as you can see, that little part that sticks out, you can pick those off and smooth it back out. This is an example of two-color printing, and it actually looks kind of cool. Here, it is now done. And now it feels kind of weird because it's all bumpy, and I don't think I've felt anything kind of like this, so it feels weird. So now we're going to do some more complicated prints. This is a marble machine. It may not look like it now, but it will later. As you can see, it looks like this kind of weird tomb at the side, but in the middle, it looks like this weird maid's ball thing. Some of the supports fell off while it was printing, but that's okay, it still got through. You can see where the support fell down. But in the end, it still worked out, which is good. And you always want to wear protection. You don't want it, like, this might maybe just break and shatter into your eyes, so that's why I have these. They're not that expensive, but if you don't wear glasses like me, it'll be kind of weird once you put them on, so you kind of have to get used to it. This is from Thingiverse, and it's made out of ABS from the 3D printer. And we had to put this part. The green part actually took a while. It took during night, because we started kind of late. And so we printed this and this part. And if you just take this part off, marbles come out! But actually, these just come out. These were connected, so that's why it popped. And we had marbles in here, but we painted acetone on here so it runs smoother. And this is acetone again. And so these are just the right size to just slide down. So I'm gonna give you a tour of this. And so there's a little marble in there. There we go. Now this is where this goes. And as you're wondering, like, what the heck is this? That actually goes with this. See, you can see it matches right here, right there. There's bearings in here, and they go through this, they go through this, and go around this. Now, it's on Thingiverse, by the way. So you kind of have to hold it. And as you can see, it fell out. So I'm just gonna fix this. It's shiny because we painted acetone on it. Now acetone is a hard chemical, so you should get a paintbrush and like paint it on one of these to make those little lines kind of go away. So these, see, if it's like a harsh thing. And now this is actually smooth. You can still see the lines, kind of, but it's actually really cool and shiny. So these are everything that I've printed. Not these or this. But these are the things that I've been using on this. Like See this? This is all shiny. Now, the doors all come in one part. We had to print all these. We had to print this, 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 and of course this, which came with this part, which I also shined it up with acetone. And acetone is actually very useful to make it all shiny and smoother. At first, this used to be all crumbly and purr, and we didn't like that. So we used the Dremel and the acetone to shine it up and not hard to do this. You can take it apart, but I don't want to because it takes forever just to take apart and put it back together.